scientists made a discovery. They discovered every human heart, approximately 40,000 or so specialized cells configured in a way that creates a neural network in the heart. It's their brain-like cells, but they're not in the brain, they're in the heart. And it's actually called the little brain in the heart. And these 40,000 specialized cells are called sensory neurites. What they found, what the scientists discovered, is that these cells think independently of the cranial brain. They feel and they remember independently of the cranial brain. And what that means, Brian, is every experience that we have, even this one right now, I'm registering this experience in two places. This is a good experience, so it's not a problem. I'm registering it in my mind, in my cranial mind, as well as in my heart. But if we were having a trauma, it would still be registered in both places. And if I tried to heal that trauma only through thinking about it or talking from my mind, it might feel incomplete. The healing may feel incomplete. And the reason is because I've only addressed what happened in here. I haven't addressed what happened in here. And we know this intuitively. When we talk about heart intelligence, what we're talking about is the ability for these neurons to communicate with the neurons in a way that is meaningful to those neurons. So earlier in this conversation, we talked about having experiences where we don't know what the answer is. There's nobody to ask. Everyone gives us a different answer. We can't Google an answer. And we don't need that because we always have this right here. These neurons are linked to a wisdom, to an intelligence that is right for us. Mine is right for me. Yours is right for you. And any question that you ask this intelligence, it will answer you in a way that will serve you in that moment. It'll never tell you to do anything dangerous or anything that would hurt anyone else. I'll give you a perfect example. I was in Australia over 9/11. Couldn't get back into my own country until the flights were flying again. And when they did fly, I was in Sydney, Australia, and there was a Boeing 747, that's a big plane, with fewer than 20 people that were gonna come to the US. And there was, at the ticket counter, we were at the gate to board, and the agent said, there's so few people, we're not gonna board by boarding rows. You can board this plane if you want to and go to America. And I said, well, you don't sound very encouraging. She says, I don't know what happened in that country. She says, but this plane's gonna go there if you wanna go there. I don't know if it's gonna happen again. I don't know if it's over, but if you wanna get on the plane, you know, get on the plane. And really didn't instill a lot of confidence in me or the other people that were there. And I said, hold that thought, just wait a minute. And I stepped around the corner. And there's a technique where you touch your heart like this. And when you touch your heart, your awareness will always go to the place where you feel the touch. So when you call your attention into your heart center in this way, and you slow your breathing, just a few breaths slower than usual. When you slow your breathing, it tells your body that you are safe. You're in a place that's safe. And when you're safe, and you feel safe, it's a switch. It's like an emotional trigger that frees the rejuvenating and the healing chemistry in the body because the stress and survival chemistry is not needed if you feel safe. So when you slow your breathing and focus in your heart, that is the doorway, and shamans will do this all the time. Monks, nuns, you see them do this all the time, to that heart intelligence. And I ask my heart, is this a safe flight for me to take? Because my head, if you ask your head, this is so interesting scientifically, because the brain's a polarity organ, left and right brain. And there's always gonna be a right and a wrong, good and a bad, success, failure. And if you ask your brain a question under pressure, your brain will go through the logic and the ego loops that will keep you from making the answer. Mm. When you ask your heart, the heart's not a polarity organ. So you consciously free yourself from those loops into what is called heart intelligence. And generally your heart will answer. Your heart knows you very well. It's been with you a long time. Your heart will answer before you even finish the question.
And so you ask, procrastinate.
You ask in a single concise sentence that the heart can respond to. Your heart doesn't need a preamble. It doesn't need a whole explanation of why you're asking. Just ask a single question. And my heart told me, and it wasn't woo-woo, airy-fairy stuff. I mean, these are neurons that understand and are cutting through, you know, all the static that would come from this. And I felt like it was a good flight. I took that flight. I got back to LA. I came back to a very different country, and there were only 9 flights to my home in New Mexico through the Albuquerque airport. And I was on one of those 9 flights, and because I trusted my heart, I got home that day. Other people were freaked out. They said, maybe they know something we don't. Maybe they had a briefing and they're not telling us, you know? And they stayed until they felt like it was safe. So it's not right, wrong, good, or bad, but we all have times in our lives where something happens and we have to make a choice, sometimes really quickly.